Hi, welcome back to the Science Labs at the Nature Museum. I'm Alan, and today we're going to talk about cockroaches, an oft-reviled and overlooked insect, but we have quite a lot to learn from them. The cockroaches we have here today make really great model organisms in classrooms for studying insects because you can really clearly see all of their body parts. Just like other insects, they have six legs, three main body parts, a head, thorax, and abdomen, and two long antennae, compound eyes, and they're all really easy to see up close. Something that everybody should know about cockroaches is that only a few species are actually pests of homes. The vast majority live out in the wild in the woodlands and help decompose wood and other things. So these cockroaches are really easy to keep because they eat a lot of leftover fruits and vegetables that we feed our other animals. So right now I've given them some apple and pear, some leafy lettuce, some cotton balls full of water to drink from, and a little bit of zucchini. So cockroaches can be great decomposers. They eat food that falls on the ground or decomposing wood or basically organic plant material. They're kind of like nature's recyclers. So some of the cockroaches we have here today are Madagascar hissing cockroaches. So they're not native to Illinois, but they make really great pets because they're large, slow moving, and they are not pests of homes. So you may be wondering why they are called Madagascar hissing cockroaches, and that's because they can make a hissing sound. They can store air inside their body and then push it out really fast through holes along the sides called spiracles. That's where they breathe through. And when they do that, it makes this hissing sound. What's great about the Madagascar hissing cockroaches is you can actually see these spiracles up close without a magnifying lens. So here we have some American cockroaches, which actually can be pests of home, so they're not recommended pets. But we have them in our educational collection here at the Nature Museum so we can get a closer look at them, as these are insects that we actually are likely to encounter in our homes. So the American roaches we feed, again, just a mixture of leftover fruits and veggies. They can help clean up the scraps for us. Something that's really interesting about cockroaches is they tend to be rather social insects. A lot of insects are solitary and live their entire lives completely alone, but different species of cockroaches live together in different ways, and they are really interesting to study then because we can learn more about different types of social structures and different types of societies. Some of the most social insects known are termites that live in massive colonies, and it was found out recently that termites are actually just social cockroaches. So you may have heard that cockroaches are one of the few organisms that would survive a nuclear detonation. However, this is false. Cockroaches, like most insects, can actually be rather sensitive to radiation. In fact, they prefer dark places and will often scurry to avoid the bright lights or the sun. So cockroaches get a bad rap because they can smell bad. They can set off allergies if little hairs on their legs break off and they get inhaled. However, they don't transmit any diseases, and the best way to keep them out of your home is just to clean up, don't leave any crumbs, don't leave any standing water, and make sure all the entrances around the outside of your home are sealed up nice and tight. Thank you for joining us. I hope you learned something about cockroaches and gained a little bit more appreciation for them. Feel free to drop any questions in the comments below, and I look forward to talking to you again. Thanks.